Hey, this is the fourth video in a tutorial series where we make this animation using a Blender Python script. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanov. I'm glad that you're joining me in this video. Let's jump into part number four. You're halfway through the tutorial series, and in this video we'll be inserting keyframes with Python to animate the deform shape key we added in the previous video. Let's start off by creating a mental model of things to come in this part of the series. We finished the previous video with a script that adds a bevel object and shape keys to the curve. We'll collapse this in our mental model into a single step. In this video, we'll start off by adding a keyframe for the shape key's value at frame 1 and at the last frame. Next, we'll set the value of the shape key to 0 and insert the keyframe into the middle of our animation, not forgetting to set the shape key value back to 1 before the third insertion. Finally, we'll group this code together and name it Animate Curve so we can reference it later. It'll be important to keep this mental model in mind as we edit our script. You can find the code we'll be starting off with on the GitHub page. I'll add a link in the description under Start Code. You can also find the code we'll have at the very end of this video, right underneath that. Before we start animating our curve, we'll need to modify our scripting workspace so we can see the timeline. On the timeline, we'll see the keyframes that we're adding. Let's go to the very bottom of this editor, and on the left, pull out the corner, pull up, and then change this to the timeline right here. Collapse this, and that's it. We have the timeline so we can see. Now I'm going to select our curve and show you how you could do this by hand so we can understand what we're going to be doing with Python. I'm going to select that. I'm going to select deform, scroll all the way down to the object properties, and at the bottom you'll find the shape keys. Select deform and then right click on the value and then insert keyframe. This will insert a keyframe that we're going to be using for our animation. Let's move this to frame 181 and then right click again and insert keyframe. So if I play, nothing's happening in this animation because we didn't change that value. Now I'm going to pause that, hitting space again, and go to frame 90, change the value to 0, hit enter, and then insert keyframe. Now when I press space, you can see in the viewport our curve is modifying, it's changing its shape based on the shape key that we defined in the previous video. I'm going to hit pause. This is what we're going to be doing with our Python script in this video. Let's get to it. We're going to start off by just running our script to clear the keyframes that were added by hand. We're going to go to the very top of the generate Perlin curve function, and at the bottom we're going to return the shape key so we can start modifying it outside of this function. Now I'm going to go to where we're calling this and get this return value. So we're calling it right here at the bottom. So now we're going to generate the curve that you see on the left and return the shape key so we can start adding the animation keyframes. Let's start adding our first keyframe with Python. We're going to go right into the main function and under Gen Perlin curve, we're going to add the code that's going to add this keyframe. We'll need the start value and we'll need the start frame. Now we need to set the value of this keyframe and insert it. All right, let's run that. I'm going to select the curve, and as you can see at the bottom in the timeline, there's one keyframe that we just inserted with Python. Let's do the same thing for the last keyframe. We'll need to calculate the current keyframe for this last keyframe, and that's going to be adding the first keyframe to the length of the loop. We'll introduce a new variable, loop length, and set it to the maximum duration of this animation, which is 180. Now let's run that. Now let's select our main curve. And as you can see at the bottom in the timeline, there are two keyframes that we just set with Python, and nothing happens if we just press space and play the animation. So now we need to add the middle keyframe that's gonna set the animation for us. To add the middle keyframe, we'll need a middle value, which is gonna be 0 for the value of the shape key. I'm just gonna copy this. The current frame for the middle keyframe is gonna be the start frame plus half of the loop length. So I'm gonna divide loop length by 2 and set the shape key value to the mid value we just created. Let's run that script. I'm gonna select the curve. And as you can see, now we have 3 keyframes, and I'm gonna hit space. And if you look at the viewport right here, as the animation goes, our curve is getting modified and deformed. I'm gonna hit pause. Now let's create a function animate curve that's gonna contain this animation code. I'm gonna select the code that's generating the animation, hit Control X, go right up here, paste what we just cut. We're using two things here. We're using the context and the shape key, and we need to provide them as parameters to this function. I'm gonna copy this and set it as the first parameter, and I'm gonna copy the shape key and set it as the second parameter. Now, if I run this, we'll stop adding the keyframes because we're not calling this function. Let's do that. I'm gonna select and copy this right underneath the generate Perlin curve. Now let's run it. I'm gonna select the curve, and as you can see now, it's working again. Now let's add our final touch, is group this code right here as a gen scene. I'm gonna cut that, Control X and define. And since in the gen scene we're using context, I need to pass that in. And if I run this, nothing's gonna be added to the scene because we're not calling this gen scene function. So now let me copy that and add it to main. And now let's run it. Select our curve. And as you can see, we have our animation playing back. Everything's working. Make sure to save your progress. If you have any questions, make sure to ask them in the comments below. In the next video, we'll be stacking the curves to make the final shape. Make sure to subscribe to not miss it.